Recently, the first ever identified interstellar object, Oumuamua, was discovered. Contrary to what one might expect, a comet or asteroid or other such familiar object we see in our own solar system, Oumuamua has proven to be extraordinarily strange on a number of fronts, and does not fit well in either category. So here are 10 reasons why our first interstellar visitor is blowing our minds. Number 10. We have no idea where this object is from, and probably never will. The problem with figuring out just where Oumuamua originally came from is that the galaxy is something like a game of pool. Like a ball, after so many changes in trajectory as it encounters gravitational objects like stars, the information of its origins is simply lost, and cannot be reliably reconstructed past a few tens of millions of years. Oumuamua may well be far older than that, with some estimates suggesting that it could have completed multiple revolutions around the galaxy since it left its home star system. That could mean that not only is Oumuamua an interstellar object, not very likely to be from the local area of the galaxy, but could be from an entirely different part of the galaxy altogether. There have been some speculations of the origins of Oumuamua, such as the Carina or Columba associations of stars, which, if that's the case, Oumuamua left one of the stars in those associations about 45 million years ago. But there are problems there, and peculiarities about Oumuamua's motion seem to support that this is a very ancient object that's been wandering space for a very long time, and, in that case, we'll probably never know its origins. Number 9. Oumuamua may have an exotic astrophysical origin. Given that the origins of Oumuamua are shrouded in the mists of time, it's difficult to know exactly what the nature of this object is. What we do know is that it's very strange, unlike anything we've seen in our sampling of our own solar system. Initially classed as a comet, it quickly became evident that it probably wasn't one due to a lack of outgassing from the object and the formation of a coma and tail. That left a somewhat less likely asteroidal origin for the object. Asteroids are thought to be less common in the Milky Way than cometary material is. But that didn't fit well either. Firstly, the shape of the object appeared to be either elongated like a cigar, or flat like a pancake, according to observations of its light curve, revealing that the object was tumbling. The object also appeared to be far more elongated than any object seen in our own solar system. This opened the object up to presumably less common natural origins. One of these is that Oumuamua is in fact a fragment of a tidally disrupted planet that was torn apart in the system of origin. This would naturally be unlike anything we've seen so far in our solar system, and might explain the object's strange behavior and shape. Other options include an object originating from a white dwarf system, or even a supernova, both of which it's unclear what sorts of objects they might produce. Lastly, as Karen Meech at the University of Hawaii, one of the researchers studying the object, notes, it cannot be ruled out that Oumuamua is actually of artificial origin. Be sure to check out my interview on this channel with Dr. Meech, link in the end screen of this video. Number 8. We should have never seen Oumuamua in the first place. One of the more intriguing aspects of Oumuamua is that we probably should have never spotted it at all. Three things are at play here. The first is that Oumuamua just happened to pass close enough to Earth for us to spot it. It's a pretty tiny object that was spotted only because of its odd attributes. Otherwise, we'd have missed it. But there are other reasons that serendipity came into play in discovering it. In a 2009 paper by Amaya Morrow-Martin and colleagues, link in the description below, they detailed that if extrasolar comets were common in our solar system, then we should have detected them by now. A comet traveling across space over a period of millions of years should retain its volatile ices, and it's likely that at least some exocomets of interstellar origins should be fresh comets from Oort cloud analogs that have never encountered stars closely before. So when passing close to a star like the Sun, these comets should outgas just as normal solar system comets do, perhaps even spectacularly. The best and brightest comets tend to be fresh ones. Yet, in the several centuries that comets have been studied, not a single one has been observed passing through the solar system that can be assigned to an interstellar origin. This is not to say that there aren't candidates in our solar system that may have once been interstellar and were captured in the past by Jupiter. In fact, there are two candidates for this. But it's not entirely clear when those objects might have been captured, whether millions or billions of years ago. If extrasolar comets are indeed rare, then asteroids would likely be even scarcer. The paper goes on to show that for these objects to be common, each star system in the Milky Way would need to eject about 10 to the 15th such objects across its lifetime. That seems to be far more than our own solar system produces. So we're either an exception, and that there are stars out there ejecting truly huge amounts of interstellar objects, or that interstellar objects may be significantly rarer than some might think. If that's the case, then Oumuamua is especially weird for two reasons. First is that we just happened to spot it as it passed through. If these objects are rare, then that's some serious odds. The other is that Oumuamua wouldn't have been spotted if it weren't for luck. Several serendipitous observations before and after that happened to catch the object in their field of view helped determine that Oumuamua was something unusual. Number 7. Oumuamua may be extremely ancient. Several aspects of Oumuamua, including its apparently reddened surface, suggest it spent quite a lot of time in interstellar space, and clues from the way it moves through the galaxy are suggestive that this object not only may have originated in another part of the galaxy, but it also might have done so a very long time ago. One possibility with Oumuamua is that it has continuously orbited the center of the galaxy multiple times, and may have left its parent system under whatever circumstances were present, perhaps billions of years ago, only through eventually catching up with the object with a probe, which is marginally possible with technology we have today, and maybe even easier in the future, will shed light on just how old this object is. Number 6. Oumuamua passed suspiciously close to Earth. Oumuamua's trajectory within the solar system could have taken any number of paths, depending on the origin and path it took through interstellar space. It just so happened entirely by chance that Oumuamua came in from above the plane of the solar system, from the apparent direction of the bright night sky star Vega, though it could not have originated there, as Vega was not in the position it is today when Oumuamua passed that area of space. The object then passed close to the Sun, about 0.255 astronomical units, and because of the Sun's gravity, it took a turn and then encountered Earth at the closest approach of about 0.15 astronomical units. Now that proximity was a factor in our being able to discover Oumuamua at all, so it could simply be that the solar system has many such objects at any given time, and that this one just happened to be the one that passed close enough to Earth for us to see it. However, in coming years, if it's found that interstellar objects similar to Oumuamua are rare or even unheard of, then this close of a pass to Earth may become very interesting indeed. Number 5. Oumuamua left its home system with a massive kick. Oumuamua's circumstances regarding its motion through space are twofold. There are oddities in how it entered the solar system and how it left the solar system, more on that in a minute. Whatever its origins, they had to be unusual in that the object seems to have had to leave its originating system with an unusually large kick, if it were from a normal star system. This opens up possibilities such as an origin within a binary star system, or a supernova, or even artificial acceleration initially. You'd think a run-of-the-mill object wouldn't have so many strange features, especially since it's the first such object we've seen. It should have been far more boring than this, statistically speaking. Number 4. Oumuamua's motion through the galaxy raises eyebrows. If Oumuamua's hidden origins weren't enough, it also happens to occupy a significant frame of reference within the galaxy, called the LSR, or Local Standard of Rest. Essentially, Oumuamua, while seemingly traveling very fast through the solar system, it is not traveling very fast through the Milky Way. In fact, only 1 in 500 stars is moving as slow as Oumuamua within that frame of reference. In short, our solar system rammed into Oumuamua. This could mean several things, such as Oumuamua has been out there in interstellar space for a very, very long time, at least several revolutions of the galaxy, which is likely the case. Or it may be something else. In an article by Abraham Loeb, linked below, and linked to my interviews with Dr. Loeb on this channel in the description below, it's advanced that this might be an ideal way to hide the origins of an object if you really wanted to. Number 3. Oumuamua has an extremely strange shape. One of the bigger issues with exploring Oumuamua is figuring out its shape. This is done through studying its light curve, variations in how it reflects light as it moves. This has led to several interpretations. One is that Oumuamua is cigar-shaped and tumbling. This would make it unusually long and thin for a natural object, but not impossible. Another interpretation is that the object is flattened and more like a pancake in shape. Again, this would be unusual, but if Oumuamua is a small object, it wouldn't be that implausible. A third interpretation is that Oumuamua is very thin, less than a millimeter thick, which would account for Oumuamua's movements through solar radiation pressure. It's difficult to imagine what in nature would produce a thin sheet of material, though the dynamics of protoplanetary disks, or what could happen in a supernova, are unknown. But geology on Earth can produce rocks that are thin. But if you really wanted to construct an artificial solar sail, it would look like that as well. Number 2. Oumuamua seems to be unusually reflective. Yet another mystery of Oumuamua is that if it's so small, which it apparently is, then why would we see it at all? The answer is that it must be highly reflective. A natural explanation for this might be that Oumuamua is really just a piece of mostly pure water ice. This would explain the lack of observation of outgassing, since water ice was not detectable in the data that was taken by Spitzer. It's possible that this water ice entered the solar system covered in reddened dust, as might be expected for a comet, and as that ice evaporated near the sun, it may have stripped off that layer of dust, leaving a highly reflective icy surface behind. But, as Dr. Loeb points out, it would also be consistent with a reflective artificial light sail. Number 1. Oumuamua accelerated as it left the solar system. Perhaps the strangest aspect of Oumuamua is that as it left the inner solar system, it was found to have accelerated on its way out, meaning that it's moving faster than it should be given the gravitational effects of the sun on it. This was not a huge acceleration, about a tenth of a percent. Indeed, it really should be said that it left our solar system less slow than it should have, but it was an acceleration nonetheless. If Oumuamua were a comet, this would be easily explained. Volatile ices and comets as they near a star can warm up and outgas, which can act as a thruster of sorts and accelerate the comet. However, this is usually observed with comets as dust is blown off the surface. This was not seen with Oumuamua, nor were there spectrographic indications of gases typical of this. Given the nature of those spectrographic observations, it's possible that water ice might have been the culprit and would have been missed. But again, the usual coma that should have formed around the object wasn't observed. Possibly the outgassing was very slow, but in any case, outgassing in most cases should have altered how the object was spinning. That was not observed either. For some random object entering the solar system, Oumuamua seems very strange indeed. This led to the proposition that Oumuamua may be acting, or is, a light sail being affected by radiation pressure from the sun causing the acceleration. If it was being pushed by radiation pressure, Oumuamua would need to be less than a millimeter thick and tens of meters wide, much like one would expect from an artificial light sail. While it's highly unlikely we'd just happen to catch some exocivilization's light sail in the act of checking out Earth, there would have to be a whole lot of these things passing through the solar system at any given time. And the tumbling aspect of Oumuamua doesn't seem to match a light sail, nor does the relatively slow speed of the object. It's still a possibility on the table, however. Oumuamua, whether natural or artificial, shows us that the universe is a very strange place, and as our technology improves, we will gain the ability to detect further objects like this. If we see more, then we have many opportunities to study them. If we don't see more, we know Oumuamua was something very strange and special. And while it remains very likely that Oumuamua is a natural object, to speculate, what if it's not? What might an alien solar sail tell us of other civilizations? Will future objects like this turn out to be how we answer the "Are we alone?" question, not with radio signals or exoplanet biosignatures, but within an entirely new discipline, exoarchaeology, where we may study hands-on the evidence of a distant alien civilization. But the possibilities don't just end at interstellar objects passing through the solar system. Some of them, through the actions of Jupiter, should get captured and then guided into distinctive orbits by that planet. If so, a treasure trove of formerly interstellar objects may await us to study at our leisure. And while no doubt most of them will be captured exocomets and asteroids, which in themselves could reveal information about the origins of life itself at large in the Milky Way, but maybe, just maybe, we might find something else, and evidence of exocivilizations was far closer than we might have ever imagined. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Gaudier, host of Event Horizon, where each week on this channel we explore the mysteries of science, futurism, and the universe with long-form interviews every Thursday, and random standalone content when we run across things we think you'll enjoy. Thanks again, and see you Thursday.